I'm Mike Wetzel, President and CEO of Air Innovations. To build an isolation room, a true isolation room, which, you know, meets the CDC and the AIA guidelines, it has to have a dedicated HVAC system, dedicated filtration system. It really is an isolated environment in the middle of a hospital. Right? It doesn't share anything. It doesn't share controls. It doesn't share air. You can't have cross-contamination. You have pressure control, negative pressure or positive pressure control. And so it's really, as the name would tell you, it's an isolated space inside a hospital. And they're very expensive to build and impossible to just add. We came upon the idea of a portable unit that could convert any standard patient room into an isolation room. Each of the elements inside of isolation has a particular purpose and a function, right? And we really start with specifications and codes of isolation rooms. So an isolation space is typically known for being negative pressure isolation, right? That's that most common, people know about it, and it's sort of come common words now is negative pressure, right? And what we're doing is we're lowering the pressure in the space compared to all the spaces around it so that there's a leak into the space. And that keeps everything contained in the space so that the contamination can't filter out through the door. It can't sneak out into the hallway and then, you know, contaminate the rest of the hospital. So by creating a negative pressure, that is used when the patient is the one that you're trying to protect the world from. The patient has something that you don't want anybody else to get. Keep the pressure negative. And to create isolation space, you have to cut the room off from the rest of the hospital. You have to close off the HVAC system from the rest of the hospital so that you're not pumping air-conditioned central air from the hospital into it, nor returning air to the central system, because that's just going to be a means of cross-contamination, and you're just going to move your virus all over the hospital. We shut it off, completely shut it off. Well, so if you shut off the room entirely and you leave somebody in there for 4 or 5 days with no air conditioning, you can only imagine the problem. And so there's a code, there's a requirement that you have to maintain temperature control and by the AIA, and we maintain temperature control, cooling or heating as needed. The other thing that's often overlooked is because we have onboard cooling and heating, we also dehumidify. And so if there's a kind of an increase in humidity levels in that space, so we think about people being in there and you don't have as much air exchange, you could have humidity increase. Well, having air conditioning system on board is constantly removing that moisture from the air. So less likely to have mold problems. The whole health and well-being is far better. One of the things they require is a certain number of air changes per hour in the room going through HEPA filters. And the reason that they're gonna require a certain number of air changes in the room is to clean the air in the room of particles, and it's the particles that the viruses will ride around on. A virus is a very small element, or much smaller than what a HEPA filter would typically capture. So if you look at the specs of a HEPA filter and you look at a virus is smaller. But a virus moves through the air by being attached to a bigger particle. It doesn't move around on its own. So a HEPA filter will catch that bigger particle. And so by rotating the air enough times per hour, you reduce the number of particles that are present in the air at any one time, thereby reducing the number of viruses that are potentially in the air at any one time. We additionally back all of our filters with UV light. Now that's not something that comes from CDC and AIA, but it is known practice in the industry that if you catch those particles that have viables, that virus is something that's alive on the particle, on the back of the HEPA filter, and you bathe that back of that HEPA filter in UV light, you will sterilize the virus. And once you sterilize the virus, it's no longer able to reproduce. And even if you were to ingest it, it can't contaminate you because it can't reproduce in your body. We're helping in the medical industry with isolation room, but also to store sterile products that might otherwise contaminate a patient. So a lot of things we do have profound impacts on society or people. So that's a fantastic thing if we can save lives.